Hi students, welcome back to Google Classroom, Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. How are you children? Hope you all are fine over there. Today we will start a new chapter in history, that is chapter 10, New Empires and Kingdoms. Before entering to the class, let me talk about some important tips related to this chapter. This chapter has a lot of important and very confusing information. So, for the better understanding, the chapter is mainly divided into four broad categories.
They are Samudragupta, Harshavardhana, Pallavas and Chalukyas, and the last one is Kingdoms. At first, we will discuss about Samudragupta. Samudragupta was a famous ruler of a dynasty known as the Guptas. My children, how do we know about Samudragupta? Did you remember that? You already studied about a long inscription inscribed on the Ashokan pillar at Allahabad, which tells us about Samudragupta. And it was composed as a Kavya. Kavya means poem. And it was composed by Harishena. Who was Harishena? Harishena was a poet and a minister at the court of Samudragupta. And this inscription is of a special kind and it is known as the Prashasti. Then, what is Prashasti? Prashasti is a Sanskrit word and it means in praise of. And Prashastis are special kinds of inscriptions. And it was composed for many rulers like Gautamiputra Sri Satakarni. But they became more important from the time of the Guptas. And in Samudragupta's Prashasti, the poet praised the king a lot. As a warrior, as a king who won victories in battle, and at the same time, he was learned and the best of poets. And here you can see one of the Prashasti related to Samudragupta. And the poet described Samudragupta as equal to the gods. And this Prashasti was composed in very long sentences. Besides, in the Prashasti, Harishena describes four different kinds of rulers. He also tells us Samudragupta's policies towards them. So, what are the different kinds of rulers? Rulers of Aryavarta, rulers of Dakshinapada, inner circle of neighboring states, and the rulers of outlying areas. Let's discuss each of these in detail. The first one is rulers of Aryavarta. Children, in this map, you can see the area shown in green color. That is the area which was under the Aryavarta. Here, nine rulers were defeated by Samudragupta. As a result, their kingdoms were made a part of Samudragupta's empire. And the next one is rulers of Dakshinapada. In this map, you can see some capitals of Dakshinapada kingdoms are marked on the map by red dots. And here there were 12 rulers and Samudragupta defeated them. As a result of this, they surrendered to Samudragupta. After that, Samudragupta allowed them to rule again. And the third one is neighboring states. Here in this map, you can see the area marked in pink color that denotes the inner circle of neighboring states. And it included Assam, coastal Bengal, Nepal and many Gana Sanghas in the northwest. Then the rulers in these areas brought tribute to Samudragupta and they followed his orders and also attended his court. And the fourth category is rulers of outlying areas. Here in this map, you can see the area marked in blue color that is coming under outlying areas. The rulers of outlying areas were descendants of Kushanas, Shakas, and the rulers of Sri Lanka. Then the rulers in these areas submitted to Samudragupta and also offered daughters in marriage. From all these, we can understand Samudragupta was a very powerful ruler in Gupta dynasty. Then let's talk about some important centers of the Gupta rulers. Important centers of the Gupta rulers were Prayaga, Ujjain and Pataliputra. Prayag was the old name for present-day Allahabad. And Pataliputra was the present-day Patna. And children, we already discussed that Samudragupta was a very powerful ruler. And at the same time, some other qualities of Samudragupta are shown on coins. For example, the coin where he is shown playing the veena. And he was a poet and a musician also. So these are the various qualities of Samudragupta. And in the next class, we will discuss the other rulers of Gupta dynasty.
So students, I hope all of you understood the concept clearly. And please note that the related URLs, notes of the lesson and test paper are also attached along with the class. Make use of these available materials. Study well and attend the test paper without fail. That's all for today. Thank you.